It was coined very early on that we're on the amazing Appomattox. And I do truly believe that this is an amazing Appomattox.
16 stories high, 2 football fields wide, and weighing more than an aircraft carrier, this extraordinary looking construction will soon become one of the world's largest oil platforms, the amazing Appomattox. This is the story of how it was designed and built. GEOJE, South Korea. Thousands of workers pour into one of the world's largest shipyards, many of them to work on the Appomattox. It's taken nearly 4 years of design to get to this point, involving hundreds of engineers who faced a monumental challenge to create a state-of-the-art, greener, longer-lasting oil platform that's bigger than any other Shell has ever built.
There have been a lot of design challenges. There's been a lot of installation challenges. We had so many challenges that we had never even thought about before.
Over the past 2 years, large modules were constructed on the quayside, then lifted by gigantic cranes and stacked on top of each other with inch-perfect precision. It's a bit like making a giant 3D puzzle. The platform's designers also had their own puzzle to solve. How to make Appomattox last for 40 years? That's double the lifespan of most other platforms.
Over the course of that time, it's going to see some of the worst weather conditions on the planet. So we have to build it with the utmost quality because there's a lot of lives who will be on there 7 days a week, 24 hours a day, that depend on it.
The oil platform will be located 80 miles from the Louisiana coast, in water a mile and a half deep.
7,000 foot of water, that's what a lot of them are very amazed by. It just floats on water.
When you think about it, it's pretty amazing that something that big actually floats, but it does.
The oil reservoir is another 14,000 feet below the seabed. When Appomattox is up and running, crude oil from subsea wells will be processed, cleaned, and separated into oil and different gases. It's a process that requires a lot of energy.
The power plant on Appomattox is 150 megawatts, and that's 5 times larger than our next largest facility, and is enough to power about 100,000 homes.
Most oil platforms are powered by diesel generators, but in a drive to be more environmentally friendly, Appomattox is fully electric, reducing emissions by 25%. To achieve this, they took a leaf out of the book of the electric car manufacturer, Tesla.
Electrifying a car allows you to completely optimize that car around that electrification. And that is basically what we've done with Appomattox. We've made it your Tesla car with one centralized electricity system as low in terms of emission impact on the environment as possible.
The team designed an ultra-efficient method of generating electricity using natural gas and steam turbines. But it's a process that generates a lot of heat that would require a huge amount of water for cooling.
We realized that we needed 2.5 million barrels of seawater a day. That's about the amount of water you would need for Houston's potable water supply every day. We started to question, well, what is the environmental impact of that type of consumption?
The welds in between. The team faced a double challenge, to use less water and ensure marine life is unaffected. Specialist marine researchers were drafted in to help. They discovered that at a depth of 2,000 feet, the water in this part of the Gulf of Mexico was so much colder, they could cut their consumption in half.
And so we made a project decision to source water from 2,000 feet deep.
The sea life they found at this depth was mostly very small fish and crustaceans, including one called Phronema. It's believed to be the inspiration for the 1986 movie, Aliens.
It was a creature that lived inside of another creature for protection. He's got a little mouth that comes and sticks out, and he's just a terrifying little creature.
researchers discovered that Fronema swims at a half foot per second, which gave them an idea. To use multiple water intake pipes, pulling water from 2,000 feet, slowly enough to allow Fronema and friends to stay out of harm's way.
So if you had asked us early on, we would never have told you that a critical factor in the design would have been the speed at which small fish swim.
But with one challenge resolved, another one was looming. Engineers needed a pipe insulation that could last four decades and withstand big temperature fluctuations, 7,000 feet under the sea.
The insulation system probably posed the greatest challenge. We really didn't have a solution when we started.
For help, the team turned to a group of Caltech scientists testing a chemical catalyst used in a very different field.
It's the kind of solution only chemists could come up with. So they have a catalyst that they use for hepatitis vaccines, and they mix that with a chemical that we use to make synthetic oil. That turns into insulation that we can put on pipe and then put in 7,000 feet of water.
The catalyst created insulation that was long-lasting, extremely strong, and pliable. Qualities that have made it a contender for a completely different application. Bulletproof vests. And it wasn't just the pipe insulation that had to last for 40 years. Another major challenge was the limited lifespan of tanks needed to store corrosive chemicals.
And chemical storage tanks often pose a challenge just due to the nature of the chemicals. You're never sure exactly how it's going to react with the steel structure.
Engineers calculated that even if they lined or reinforced the tanks, they still might not last long enough. The solution? To design tanks to be fully extractable. If long-term exposure to corrosive chemicals damages them, they can simply be plucked out of the hull, sent back to shore, and replaced.
Some of these items are actually completely serial number one. They're brand new, not only to Shell, but to the world.
With all the design challenges overcome,
call for a celebration.
Appomattox is now off the drawing board and into construction. In South Texas, four modules that form the top of the platform are being made. One provides power, another processes oil and gas. A third is for utilities like drinking water and sewage processing, and the fourth is the living quarters. Each weighs about 10,000 tons and will be lifted onto the hull.
That lift is the culmination of 3 years of hard work and execution. And once it's set down in the hull, it's not coming back up until the platform's decommissioned 40 years later.
And now it's time to get to work on those modules and deck lifts.
I particularly like all the big lifts. And so every time we make a 1,500 ton deck lift and lift it up and set it on 15 points without causing a clash, that's huge. That's really huge. It's really exciting to pull that off.
Enormous shipyard cranes pick up the modules, lift them 60 feet into the air, and delicately place them on the hull.
We did that three times, and each one was just as impressive as the last. That's why I do this.
For 6 months, construction goes nonstop from sunrise to sunset. Appomattox is transformed from a hull into an oil platform. It's now 29 stories tall, 2 football fields wide, and will house 180 personnel all year round.
I'm proud of it, and I'm proud of to be a part of the team that helped push this through.
It was really amazing to be able to see something from design through fabrication, and now installation and construction. We're truly driving technology and innovation forward.
The experience was incredible. For us to be part of such an incredible project and to have the success that we actually were able to provide, it will be something that we will never forget.
In the next episode of the amazing Appomattox story, see how it tried to outrun a super typhoon on its journey across the world from South Korea to the Gulf of Mexico. Subscribe to Shell's YouTube channel to see more on the amazing Appomattox oil platform and other technology and engineering films from Shell.